Lakshmi ma'am. The rest should be the school students, okay ma'am?
A phenomenal morning to one and all gathered here. We are happy to present you the webinar on careers in psychology on behalf of Sri Kanyaka Parameshwari Arts and Science College for Women and the Department of Psychology. Nivetha, could you move to the next slide, please? Prayer is a key to the soul that leads us a very bright and positive thought every moment. So here, I request all of you to kindly mute your audios so that there won't be any glitches during the prayer. Here with a prayer of Sri Kanyaka Parameshwari Arts and Science College for Women. Thank you all. Nivetha, we'll go for the next slide. So we are indeed glad to inform you all that for the upcoming year of 2021, the admissions have been started. And we are happy to share a few slide clippings of our college and to let you know all about our college. So here, which describes about our college.
Before that, Sri Varshini, may I intervene?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, I would like to welcome all the student participants of various schools. I would like to thank my management committee members, my principal ma'am. I would definitely welcome all of them virtually, though they are in a different webinar. I welcome our correspondent, Sri Gugulam Ramesh Garu, my principal ma'am, Dr. T. Mohaneshree ma'am, vice principal ma'am, Dr. P.B. Vanita ma'am, academics vice principal ma'am, Napine ma'am, and all my staff here, and the most important backbone of this seminar, this webinar rather, the school students of various other city schools here. And I would like to thank the principals of various schools who allowed you to come for this webinar. So girls, welcome for the webinar. Take the best out of it. Try to, you know, come with questions that you need really clarification with, and please utilize this webinar 100%. This is exclusively for the students' communities. I also welcome my department students and all my staff, Lakshmi ma'am, Lata ma'am, and Shanti ma'am, for this webinar. Now we will continue with the presentations. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Continue, Srivarshini. Over to Srivarshini.
Yes, ma'am. The slide is playing, ma'am.
Yes, thank you.
Dear participants, kindly please bear with us. Due to some network glitch, the video is taking time to load. Please kindly wait. The video will play very shortly.
Welcome to Sri Kaniga Parameshwari Arts and Science College for Women, a linguistic Telugu minority institution affiliated to University of Madras, accredited by NAC, having 2F status, ISO certified, and located near Madras High Court. The college has been ranked 30th at the national level and 2nd at the state level by Education World for the year 2020-2021. The courses offered in Shift 1, BCom General, BCom Corporate Secretarship, BCom Honours, BBA, BSc Computer Science, BSc Psychology, BSc Mathematics, BSc Interior Design and Decor, BCA, BA Sociology, MCom, MAHRM, MSc Computer Science, MSc Interior Design and Decor, MPhil in Commerce, PhD part-time in Commerce. In Shift 2, BCom Accounting and Finance, BCom Bank Management, BSc Computer Science, BA English Literature.
So these are the courses offered by our college. And for this current year, we have also added a new course in Shift 1, which is BA Criminology and Police Administration. Next, there comes a video which represents our department.
Arts and Science College for Women. The department was incepted in the year 2003 with a strength of 5 students and 2 faculties. Now, it has grown with a strength of 50 intake of students with 4 qualified teachers, securing 30 plus university ranks. The subject is unique of its kind and application oriented with updated syllabus. The aim of the department is to fulfill the demands of the society in handling human needs and managing behavior. The department consists of well-equipped psychology lab with various scales of assessments and well-furnished apparatus to carry out cognitive and psychological assessments. The department also have other amenities like counseling room for counseling services, anti-sexual abuse wing, well-furnished classrooms, and a general library with e-library activation facility. The proud pillars of our department are our staffs, Dr. N. Nirmala Narayanan, head of the department, Ms. M. Lata, assistant professor, Ms. M. Lakshmi, assistant professor, and Ms. C. Shanti, assistant professor. We believe in experimental learning. Thus, various activities are conducted in our department on a regular basis. We also conduct seminars and workshops frequently to enrich the knowledge. Service to mankind is service to God. Our department students contribute services to Saravodaya students in means of counseling and teaching. The department will ever strive in shaping the budding psychologist to reach greater heights through application of the subject knowledge towards self first and transform inside out for betterment, thus helping the society on a larger level. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. All about our department. And now let us see that what exactly psychology is and why people behave the way they behave. Here, we all know that psychology is a study of mind and behavior. And we all know that how important is a behavior in a society we live in. Their behavior gets them what exactly they want. The way we exhibit our behavior makes others to interpret about ours. So, have you ever asked yourself, who am I? Yeah, who am I gives the answer that what is your identity, and this exactly gives what we are. So let us see the next slide. There are various specializations in the field of psychology, and now I would like to call the speaker to talk about the other fields in the field of psychology.
Good morning to everybody. Am I audible?
Yeah, you're very much audible.
Yeah, thank you, Vashni. So, as Ms. Vashni has told, there are many specializations within the field of psychology. And there is medical field, educational field, etc. So, let me just start with the medical field. So, here there is clinical psychology, counseling psychology, medical or health psychology, psychopharmacology, and neuropsychology. So these fields come under the medical field. So let me just explain what these fields are and what the professionals associated within these fields, what they mainly explore on or what they mainly focus on. So let me just start with the clinical psychology. So what is clinical psychology? So a clinical psychologist is a mental health professional who is highly specialized, trained in the diagnosis. They are highly trained to assess, diagnose, and treat all types of mental, emotional, and behavioral problems. And most importantly, clinical psychologists do not prescribe medications to treat mental illness. So moving on to counseling psychology. So a professional counseling psychologist works to help people with psychological and emotional health concerns. They focus more on persons with adjustment problems rather than on persons suffering from severe psychological distress. So they not only focus on the person with mental or emotional distress.
Ma, Niveda, your voice is breaking, ma. Niveda.
Ma'am, for me it is clear, ma'am.
No, Niveda, voice is breaking.
Is it okay now?
The audience group, are we audible? The presentation, is it audible? Can any one of the audience groups say?
Ma'am, there is a break in the audio, ma'am.
Okay, Niveda, we request you to just check with the audibility. I agree there might be some technical glitches, but just try, Niveda. Please continue on the list. No harm. Do it. Yes, thanks.
Am I audible now?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, continue.
So counseling psychologists. So counseling psychologists work to help people with psychological and emotional health concerns. So they not only focus on persons suffering from severe psychological distress, but they also focus more on persons with adjustment problems. So next we will move on to health psychology. So what is health psychology? So health psychology field deals with the behavioral, mental, emotional and social factors that are related to physical illness. So health psychology not only focuses on the psychological problems, but in addition to that, it also focuses more on the physical illness of a particular individual. So this area is mainly concerned with health matters across a range of different groups of the public and initiate programs to help reduce them. So whenever there is a problem within a range of different groups of the public, so these health psychologists initiate programs to reduce their physical illnesses. So next we will move on to psychopharmacology. So psychopharmacology is nothing but the study of the use of medications in treating mental disorders. So these professionals use medications to treat severe mental disorders of the individuals. They need to understand all the clinically relevant principles of pharmacokinetics. Pharmacokinetics is nothing but what the body does to the medication and vice versa. That is pharmacodynamics, what the medications does to the body. So psychopharmacologists primarily need to understand all the clinically relevant principles to what the body does to medication and what the medications does to the body. So next we'll move on to neuropsychology. As the name indicates, neuro means it's associated with our brain. So neuropsychologist specializes in understanding the relationship between the physical brain and our behavior. So they assess and diagnose patients, they observe specific symptoms and use sophisticated technologies like brain scans. After that, they often recommend a course of treatment, whether a person can person requires a therapy or they require a medication or they require a surgery. So all these come under neuropsychologist field. So I'm moving on to the next slide. So here we have educational field. Educational psychology, school psychology and special education counselor. So educational psychology. What does an educational psychologist do? They work with children, adolescents and teenagers who have a learning disorder or LD, or who have social difficulties or emotional problems that negatively impact their ability to learn. Educational psychologists also work with families. So they not only work with children or teenagers, they also work with families to help them develop strategies for supporting their child's learning. So they help a family to help to develop their child's learning. So next we will move on to school psychology. What does a school psychologist do? A school psychologist helps students overcome their emotional, academic and any behavioral difficulties they have. School psychologists may counsel at-risk students, train educators on how to create safe classroom environments for these students. They design and implement school-wide strategies to prevent bullying or implement positive behavioral support systems. So next we have special education counselor. They work with special needs students in elementary schools, middle schools and high schools to ensure they have the support services they need in order to achieve their highest potential in the areas of academics, personal and social growth and career development. So moving on to the next slide. So here we have specializations in psychology and the industry or business field. So firstly, we have industrial organizational psychology, or also known as IO psychology. So this is a branch of psychology that applies psychological theories and principles to organizations. They are more focused on understanding how organizations affect an individual's behavior. So next we have HR psychology, which is nothing but human resource psychology. So these psychologists who work in human resource departments are a part of the management team that creates, directs and implements organization management theories and plans. So next we have consumer psychology. So we all are well aware of this consumer psychology. So this includes study of consumers and their behavior. This includes their wants, the consumer's wants, what they need, as well as what influences their purchasing habits. So now I hand over to Ms. K.P. Murka.
Let's see the industry and business field in that. Niveta, move on to the next slide. The society and the community field in that four psychology, environmental psychology, community psychology, social psychology, cross-culture psychology. In that, first we're going to see that environmental psychology. Environmental psychology is nothing but mainly they focuses on interplay between the individual and their surrounding. This is known as the environmental psychology. They mainly focuses on research process, how the people is working in that, and how they're responding to world around in towards it. And next one is the community psychology. In that, the nothing but the how they relate to the society. The study of the relation with the social system and the individual well-being in community context, which is known as situation towards them. And the issues is the community psychologist mainly focuses on the individual wellness and empowerment and diversity. Next one is the social psychology. Social psychology is that the how people thoughts and their feelings, belief systems and intention and their goals constructed with the social context by the interaction with the other person. And the next thing is they may influence on the one who is influencing on the individual well-being as a well as health society, including the problems such as the crime and domestic abuse and public health. They mostly focuses on this kind of things. Next one is the cross-culture psychology. In that, the study of human behavior and the mental process, including both their variability and invariance, which is known nothing but the study of similarity and differences in the one's behavior. That is the cross-culture psychology among the individuals who have developed in the different cultures. Over to next person.
Yeah, hope I'm audible. Let's see the forensic and criminology field. Forensic psychology. The practice of forensic psychology involves in investigations, research studies, assessments, consultation, and implementation of the treatment programs and expert witness courtroom testimony. So many work in areas like correction faculties, police departments, and also some involved in research fields and also teaching in about colleges and universities. And criminal psychology. Criminal psychology is a study of views, thoughts, intentions, actions, and reactions of the criminals who participate in the criminal industries. And next slide. Application of psychology in professional field. So under that we have aviation psychology, engineering psychology, military psychology. Aviation is nothing but the airfield. So aviation psychology is a specialty of psychology where workers in the field use their knowledge of human emotion and behavior to improve aviation standards and condition, provide mental health support to pilots, air crew, and air staff, and address their problems, anxieties, or job-related stresses. Engineering psychology. Engineering psychologists utilize the psychological principles to solve the real-life problems. People who work in this profession are more able to help improve and sometimes even save human lives. By minimizing the risk of accidents and errors, engineering psychologists can make products, systems, and workplaces more safer. Military psychology. Military psychology is a specialization of psychology that applies psychological sciences to promote the readiness of military members, organizations, and operations. Military psychologists provide support to military in many ways, including direct clinical care, consultation to military commanders, teaching others, supporting military training and through research relevant to military operations. I hand over to Maithili.
Okay, let's see the specialization in psychology, in that applied psychology. Applied psychology is that one who solve the problems within the human behaviors, such as the health issues and workplace issues, and also in the education. This mainly focuses on the theory and the fundamental understanding over the solution to that issues. And they can gain the skills. They can gain the skills of the applied psychology is conflict resolution, research including statistics, and managing the group dynamics. Managing whether the group is a formal or informal group, the person can able to manage that group, and the understanding the behavior of the consumer behavior. And then they can also, in career perspective, it is a versatile career, and the career outcome vary greatly. And this may be they all can work in a HR specialist, and also in the social service manager, for example NGOs, and marketing research analyst, etc. And next we're going to see the child psychologist. Child psychology is nothing but the study of subconscious and the conscious childhood development, and they study the learning patterns and the behavior development in the children's. And next, they have the specialized in the developmental psychology and abnormal and adolescent psychology. In that, the children who are suffering from trauma is nothing but the sudden incident that affects that person, or who having the physical and mental or learning disability often seek help from the child psychologist. They mostly work in the private practices, and also in the elementary and secondary school, government organization, hospitals, etc. And in that, adolescent psychology may work in between the age of the 12 to 18, they take over it. And the issues is mainly they focuses on depression, anger management, anxiety, eating disorder, and the learning disability. And also, next one is the developmental child psychology. In that, they conduct the research and the study how aging affects that child by observing their emotional and cognitive development. Cognitive is nothing but the intellectual development towards that child. And they observed mainly the child psychologist focuses on their language and moral understanding and motor skills and the social skills, etc. And the next is the abnormal child psychology. They treat the issues by child psychologist development, often result of trauma, emotions, or the physical abuse. Example, the issues they treated are the anxiety, mood disorder, mainly on the personality disorder, and depression. They all are work in the abnormal child professors and mental health professionals, etc. Next one, we're going to see the consultant. The consultant is the one, it is the special area of the psychology. They address area as they're doing the assessment and intervention at individuals or the groups under the organization level. They will assess that individual using the psychological testing and the interviews and the self-assessment. They are technically assistants to the individual or organization in recorded to the psychological aspects of their work. And mainly they offer a therapy and the treatment for the issues relating to the certain range of mental health conditions. And that the private practitioner is nothing but they have their own clinic, and the methods of performing the mental health and medical of the services. They have their own offices and typically set their own schedules, and they have their own clinic in towards it. And next one is the developmental psychology, the one who is study about the lifespan of the person, etc. Next, over to the person.
Yeah, thank you. So now we have seen the specializations in the field of psychology. and let us know what are the job opportunities available in the field of psychology. Next slide, please, Niveda. Yeah. For many of us, being a central government worker or a state government worker or an employee would be a dream. Many think only UPSC exams and other exams could lead us to work under central government or state government examinations. But it is not the true fact. Rather, even being a psychology aspirant, we are eligible to work under or to be a part of central government as well as state government employees. So let us see what are the departments available for us, which gives us job opportunities in the field of central government and state governments. Here we have Health and Family Welfare, Ministry of Labor and Employment, Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, Anthropological Survey of India, Sports Authority of India, Ministry of Defense, which has RDRO, Army, Navy and Air Force, and the Ministry of Human Resources Development, Ministry of Railways, Reserve Bank of India, Women Development and the Child Welfare, Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports, Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. You might have just wondered, really, are there available vacancies for a psychology aspirant to work there? Yeah, we work in all the fields and we are eligible to work in all the fields. So here, for certain departments, whereas when it comes, for example, for Reserve Bank of India, we are requested to write certain examination to be a part of personnel selection to take personnels and allocate people to work under Reserve Bank of India. And it applies for the many of the fields which are given here under the Department of the Central Government. For the next slide. We're going to see the national institutions where psychology aspirants have various job vacancies. So the very first and foremost is National Institute of Mental Health and Neurosciences, which is NIMHANS, situated at Bangalore. And the next could be the Central Institute of Psychiatry, National Institute for Empowerment for Persons with Intellectual Disabilities, the National Institute for Empowerment of Persons with Hearing Handicapped, and the National Institute for Empowerment of Persons with Visually Handicapped, the National Institution for Empowerment of Persons with Multiple Disabilities, the National Institute for Empowerment of Persons with Orthopedic Handicap, the National Institute for Technical Teacher Training and Research, the National Institute of Social Defenses, which comes under the domain of forensic psychology, and Rajiv Gandhi National Institute for Youth Development. These are the national institutions which provide us a lot of job vacancies as psychology aspirants. To enter into these jobs, we are requested to do our master's, which is post-graduation, and with certain qualifications in their entrance exams, with certain grades that they allocate for us. So next slide, please. Most of us think there is only possibility that a psychology aspirant could only become a counselor, but it is wrong. As we have seen the specializations in the field of psychology, there are plenty of opportunities available for us. And it is in our hands to choose the best that we need and we are expected to. Counseling comes as a very great profession that takes a lead part in psychology. So counseling as a profession, we have a lot of other job opportunities given for us. So let us discuss about them now. So being a counselor, we have a lot of works to place or taken place in family counseling centers, child candidate clinics, family courts and regular special schools, police stations, diabetic centers, cardiologist centers, in wellness centers and many more, where we play a major role. So what we are going to do there in these places? It is exactly, we are going to counsel them. We are going to counsel the clients and make them adapt with the transplantation programs or the fertility programs or any kind of health related programs that are going to opt them and make their health a little more better. So for these, we are required as counselors to deal their anxiety, to deal their panic situation and make their life a good and better when we could make this. So yes, someone has asked in the chat box that can we share this PDF. For sure, we'll try to share the PDF. And now I would like to call the next speaker for the next PPT. So next slide, please. Yeah, and I call the next speaker to take over.
Good morning. I will be talking about clinical psychology. Clinical psychology is the branch of psychology concerned with the assessment and treatment of mental illness, abnormal behavior, and psychiatric problem. A person or a student is eligible to become a clinical psychologist is when they pursue their undergraduate in psychology and pursue their postgraduate in clinical psychology. Clinical psychologists' work include assessing client needs, abilities, and behavior using variety of methods including psychometric tests, interviews, and observation. They prepare treatment programs including therapy and counseling. They also carry out applied researches and work as researchers. Second, health psychologists. Health psychologists work in both clinical and research settings. Health psychology is divided into 5 subfields: clinical health psychology, community health psychology, critical health psychology, public health psychology, and occupational health psychology. Clinical health psychologists help patients modify their behavior, present habits that lead to bad health. Community health psychologists are who work in government agencies, non-profit organizations, consulting firms, and medical centers. Critical health psychologists are activists of social justice and change, advocate on behalf of number of related issues such as how health care is provided. Public health psychologists are advocates of public policies and regulate change, work in different settings and conduct research to collect and analyze and interpret data to see how public policies work. Occupational health psychologists focus on developing and applying psychological principles to physical and mental health of working people and improve safety and well-being in workplace. Going on to counseling psychologists, usually work in consultancy, health and care services and in hospitals, prisons, and also do private practice. They do assessment, plan and implement treatment, monitor the process. Also, they contribute to research and work as trainers. Mental health technicians ensure the comfort of patients during and between treatments. They bathe, dress, feed the patients based on individual abilities, measure vital signs of patients, and help healthcare providers to take samples, track behaviors in the patients. Consultant psychologists assist management and administration within a business, basically working clinical healthcare settings. They do assessment and interventions at individual and group and organizational levels. Rehabilitation specialist, working with people whose disability make it difficult for them to engage in full spectrum of activities. They work in residential care facilities where the patients live full time. Mental health counselor, they offer guidance to individuals, couples, families, and groups who are dealing with issues that affect their mental health and well-being. Psychotherapist, usually perform therapy session under a controlled environment, use verbal interaction to explore behavior, attitude, and emotion, help clients understand and address their inner conflict. They carry out psychotherapy like couple therapy. Psychoanalyst, They are therapeutic clinicians who usually practice modern variants of therapies developed by Sigmund Freud. A psychoanalyst prompts a patient to talk about their childhood, family, relationships, dreams, fears, work life, daydreams, and anxieties. They typically use this knowledge of mind to analyze behavior and motivation. I now hand over the session to Bhuneshwari.
Sorry, it's not my topic.
Oh, it's my slide. Sorry, Bhuneshwari. Okay.
It's okay.
Good morning, everyone. So, as we all see in previous slides, there are psychologists working in various streams like hospitals and clinics, etc., as well as in industries and offices also, they play their major role. They're working as a HR manager, trainer, behavior analyst, consultant, working in a selection panel, talent management specialist, and working in NGOs also. So, let us see what are they specifically do in those streams. So, as HR manager, psychologists who work in human department or the part of the management team that creates, directs, and implements organizational management theories and plans. They predominantly deal directly with staff-related issues like hiring employees, recruiting, disciplinary procedures, and terminations. As a trainer, a trainer usually needs to manage a group of people and should carry out group coaching and group facilitation, etc. And when they train individuals, they usually motivate them using positive psychology and other concepts and help them to be more efficient. As a behavior analyst, are qualified professionals who use data-informed research to investigate and treat emotional, social, and educational and mental issues and disabilities, such as like autism spectrum disorder, as well as comorbid categories, including depression, bipolar disorder, and intellectual development delays. So as a consultant, we all know they are the person who provides professional or expert advice in a particular field. They provide the expertise that a client lacks and they operate in a professional manner. And in selection panel, they involve in a systematic process of hiring and promoting the person. They employ evidence-based practices to determine the most qualified individuals. They use assessment tools, including like interviews, personality inventories, psychomotor and physical ability tests, and work samples. So in talent management specialist, they assist in implementation of program that aim to attract, measure, and develop and manage an organization. They help in evaluating the talent strategies. They suggest talent to training and development programs to ensure organizational goals are met. And in NGOs, most psychologists working in NGOs can feel probably isolated from the profession as they work with a multidisciplinary team. And therefore, they work in association with many other professionals like social workers, therapists, and others also. So in industries, all these streams are mainly focuses on performance, communication, and professional satisfaction and safety of workers, that is employees working in an organization. Yes. That's all in industries and office. Over to the next speaker.
Thank you, Shanti. I'm going to take up school and college job opportunities for psychologists. Educational psychologists support school and the local authority to improve all children's experience of learning, and they assess difficulty of children may be having with their learning. Also, diagnostic and psychoeducational assessment, psychological counseling in educational communities. Next, educational researchers work with academic team that facilitate educational research and discovery by providing design, exercise, and measurement tools, work in universities, and perform educational research projects and develop research programs. Special educators to teach and interact with children who have a variety of disabilities. The special education are trained in special disabilities that include learning disability, speech and language impairments, visual impairments, etc. They plan activities that are specific to each student of their desired abilities. Post-secondary psychology teacher prepare courses materials such as syllabus, homework, assignments, handouts, develop instructional materials. They instruct students in a wide variety of academic and career and technical subjects beyond the high school level. They also conduct research and public scholarly papers and books. College and school counselor, also known as student counselor, work with the student, parent, and educator to help the student succeed academically and socially. They provide one-on-one emotional guidance and help students plan for their future by guiding them in building a career. School psychologists help to improve the academic achievement, promote positive behavior and mental health, support diverse learners, create safe, positive school climate, strengthen family and school partnerships. They also coordinate with school or education administration to improve school practice and policies and also for needed choices. Thank you. Next, over to the next.
Forensic sector. Forensic psychology is a applied branch of knowledge which relates psychology and justice system. To become a forensic psychologist, a student must pursue his undergraduate in any BA or BSc psychology and pursue their postgraduate in forensic psychology. It is available in forensic psychology is available in Northern India mostly rather than Southern India. Example, there is a college in Gujarat that offers forensic psychology. Forensic psychology aims to understand fundamental legal principles with emphasis on expert witness testimony, competence to stand trial, child custody, and visitation or workplace discrimination. That is, it serves the expectations of legal needs and requirements. The forensic psychology must have an in-depth knowledge of various statutes, laws, legal provisions framed. Forensic psychologists help to decide the legal competency of a person to stand trial and mainly by establishing the insanity of the person at the time of committing crime to assert criminal responsibility. They recommend death sentences, psychological treatment, assessment of future risk, evaluation of the accuracy and credibility of the witness. They also develop recruitment training evaluation, assessment programs for police and other law enforcement personnel. They work in applied settings like prisons, mainly juvenile prisons, rehabilitation centers, police department, law firms, schools, government agency, and also private practitioners. First, correctional counselors offers treatment and counseling to inmates of the jails and ex-convicts. Through counseling session, conducting psychological evaluation, and collaborating with case workers, lawyers, and employers of the correctional facility. Correctional counselor provide deeper insight into the state and well-being of inmate and give recommendation into parole hearing. To imagine the work of a correctional counselor, you could see it in the movie Master, where the hero goes to a juvenile prison and gives them counseling session. Next, crime analyst. They work closely with law enforcement agencies to sort crime profiles and detect criminals. They study and use statistical data to avoid future crimes. Victim advocate. Victim advocates directly work with victims of crimes and survivors of traumatic events like sexual assault or domestic violence. They provide to help them understand and attend the hearing with the victims. Jury consultants. Jury consultants work with lawyers. Jury consultants work with lawyers to provide insight on which jurors to select for cases. A juror, a set of 12 people who can decide whether the person is guilty or not based on the evidence and facts presented in the courtroom. But in India, it was abolished. Jury consultants know the body language and behavior of the juror. This helps lawyer to prepare the strategy and coach witnesses. Federal government employees. A person with forensic degree are eligible candidates for jobs like in CBI, National Security, Narcotic Control Bureau, National Investigation Agency, and Intelligence Bureau. Police consultant. Police consultant. For many cases, the police officer and detectives rely on forensic psychologists to help them understand the minds of criminals, to help them apprehend felons. Also provide suicide prevention training to communities, anger management, and how the police officers to have better handle disabled and mentally ill people. Next, licensed professional clinical counselor. It focuses on dealing with criminal defendants, sex offenders, victims by providing psychotherapeutic services to them. Last, probation officer. Probation officer assists in supervising people who were recently released from prison system and people who are placed on parole. They help in determine the release date, evaluate the likelihood of risky behavior, advising past offenders. Someone asked in the chat box what you have to do to go into forensic psychology. First, you have to pursue your undergraduate in psychology, BSc or BA psychology, anyone, and you have to pursue your postgraduate in forensic psychology. Thank you. I now hand over the session to Nandini.
NGO in psychology. NGO is nothing but non-government organization. Sometimes they come under government, come as a government employee, and sometimes they work under a private companies. So psychologists working in NGOs can feel isolated from their own profession. They may be the only psychologist within a multidisciplinary team, and therefore spend more time associating and collaborating with colleagues from other disciplines such as social work, occupational therapy, or nursing. So sometimes a non-governmental organization is also called as NFP. NFP is nothing but not-for-profit organization. As the name indicates, these psychologists work without a profit. They work only for the welfare of the people and for the services. NGOs are active in a wide range area such as child mental health, schizophrenia and psychotic conditions, drug and alcoholic abuse, dementia, etc. Their activities are included treatment, rehabilitation, community case, research, training and capacity building, awareness and lobbying. NGO psychologists sometimes act as social psychologists. Social psychologists is nothing but social psychologists study interpersonal and group dynamics and social changes such as prejudice, bullying, criminal activity, and substance abuse. Environmental psychologists, they often investigate how people work with and respond to the world around them. And community psychologists try to promote healthy and empowered group and communities. They use concepts and knowledge from a variety of disciplines, such as social, ecological, environmental, and cross-cultural psychology. Political strategies. As the name indicates, during politics, they learn about the strategies behind all the politics sectors. And public relations specialist. Public relations specialist is nothing but working on designing and marketing paid ads, content marketing efforts, etc. Social service representative. Social services representative is the authorized title for position in which there is direct responsibility for providing assistance and services on a regular continuing basis in assignments planned for the purpose. I'll hand over the session to the next person.
Yes.
Nivita, the next slide, next please.
Other jobs. As you can see before, there are various job facilities for psychologists, and they also, these are other jobs that they can do. There are art therapist, music and movement therapist, hypnotherapist, as a researcher, research analyst, freelancer, private practice, recreational therapist, etc. So what art therapy is a form of expressive therapy that uses the creative program of making art to improve a person's physical, mental, and emotional well-being. Art therapy are used by art therapists as well as other psychologists also. In clinical counseling psychologists, they use also this art therapy as a part of their counseling session. But art therapists are fully specifically trained for this art therapy. And it's sometimes called creative art therapy or expressive art therapy. It encourages people to express and understand emotions through artistic expression and through creative process. So art therapists are trained in both therapy and art. And they have studied mastering both psychology and human developing, having received a master's degree. They can help an individual, couples, a family, or a group of people. And depending on the situation, there may be numerous therapists working together as a clinical team. So art therapists are trained to pick up on non-verbal symbols and metaphors that are often expressed through art and the creative process. Concepts that are usually difficult to express with words. So next one is music and movement therapist. So movement or music therapy encourages physical response and interaction to individual and group settings to enhance physical and emotional health. So music, both it can directly affect changes in emotional, cognition, and physical functioning and human behavior. Member will be able to develop their self and other awareness, improve their confidence, and enhance the self-esteem and improve interaction and socialization also. It decreases muscle tension. And for this, they have to be as a credential RDMT therapist. RDMT is a registered dance movement therapy. So they have this credential for this music and movement therapist. And completing the alternative route of RDMT certification through an independent process of training, coursework, fieldwork, or internship. And art and music therapist need to complete or relevant diploma or master degree in their field. Most professionals who choose to pursue this specifically as usually already they obtained an undergraduate degree or a qualification in art. Next one is hypnotherapist. So during hypnosis, a trained hypnotherapist or psychologist uses guided relaxation technique to elicit feelings of extreme relaxation. They focuses on concentration in the individual with goal of helping him or her achieve a heightened state of consciousness. So it approved by the National Council of Hypnotherapy, the National Hypnotherapy Society, or a General Hypnotherapy Standard Council is highly desirable. And research psychologists study a broad range of human and animal behavior. They design and conduct experiments exploring how people act, think, behave, interact, and learn, feeling, and perform under different conditions. So for a research psychologist, they need to earn a bachelor's degree and earn a master's degree. And after that postdoctoral internship or the degree, they apply for the license, and they are considered as a registered psychology researcher. And psychoanalyst, which is a person who practices Freudian psychoanalytical therapy. So mostly recreational therapists engage patients in therapeutic activities such as swimming or any other physical activities. Recreational therapists plan, directs, and coordinate research-based treatment programs for people with disabilities, injuries, or illness. So to become a certified therapist, they must have a bachelor degree in recreational therapy or related field, or have worked for 5 or more years in therapeutic recreation services. Mental health therapists are required to have a degree and be licensed. And next one is to become a and next I'm going to tell about some common information about clinical psychologist. There's something called RCI. RCI is a Rehabilitation Council of India. So many of the students are here, or they plan to be a psychologist. Some of them plan to be clinical psychologists also. And for them, this information is very useful. To become a registered clinical psychologist in India, you need to take a license from Rehabilitation Council of India, RCI. And they are also having some professional. There are 16 categories of professionals have been covered under RCI Act. So let me quickly those tell the 16 professionals. First one is audiologist and speech therapist. Next one is clinical psychologist. Next one is hearing and hear mouth technician. Next one is rehabilitation engineers and technician. Fifth one is special teachers for educating and training the handicapped. Sixth one is vocational counselors, employment officers, and placement officers. Seventh one is multi-purpose rehabilitation therapist technician. Eighth one is speech pathologist. Ninth one is rehabilitation psychologist. 10th one is rehabilitation social workers. 11th one is rehabilitation practitioners in mental retardation. 12th one is orientation and mobility specialist. 13th one is community-based rehabilitation professionals. 14th one is rehabilitation counselors, administrators. 5th one is prosthetic and orthotist. 16th one is rehabilitation workshop managers. However, professionals like physiotherapist and occupational therapist are not covered under the RCI Act. So after you're completing your UG degree, you can go into this all fields. So that's it. Thank you. Over to next speaker. Srivashni, you can take it.
Yeah. So thank you so much. As we have seen, the specializations, various specializations available in the field of psychology. And then we have discussed about the opportunities, job opportunities available for the psychology aspirants. So to let you all know that we are very happy and proud to say many of our alumni of our department, of our college, have placed in these various jobs that we have discussed. So I would just like to give a gist out of it. So Ms. Selva Priya is working as a junior analyst in the Defense Research and Development Organization. And Ms. Pearl Mercy Dupavati is an HRD consultant in HCF And Mrs. Vanita is working as a clinical psychologist, and Ms. Divya Prabha is also working. So she's a counseling psychologist. And Ms. B. Pooja is a school educator as well as a research analyst. And Ms. Shanta Kumari is working as an assistant professor in CTT College in Chennai. And Mrs. Deepika, she's also working as an assistant professor in St. Thomas Arts and Science College. And Ms. Kritika is also working as an assistant professor in Apollo Arts and Science College for women, I guess. And Ms. Harti is working as a school psychologist. And Ms. Yogeshwari is a special educator training people with learning disabilities under a private sector. And Ms. Abhirami is a research analyst under Schizophrenia Research Foundation. So you can all see that from the very first slide that we started with the job opportunity available for the psychology aspirants till the last slide, you can at least find our alumni being placed in any one of these. So this shows that psychology is a very, very vast subject, which gives you various paths to travel in, to explore a lot, and it is in our hands to choose choose the path that we need. So yeah, our next slide please, Niveta. So as we have discussed about the specializations in the field of psychology and the job opportunities available for many school students, especially this webinar, as it was planned for exclusively the higher secondary students, you will have a lot of questions to ask, and you might have a lot of queries in your mind regarding these. And as we have discussed about all these specializations and job opportunities, you might have come up with a lot of queries. So it is an open platform to put forth your questions. So here I would like to put forth that you are open to ask any questions to the expert over here. So ma'am, please kindly answer the questions by the students.
We request the students, the plus two students who are, you know, planning to pursue different courses for your future, to come forward with your questions. Thank you, Ajay Jadhav. Very informative and useful session for higher secondary students. Congratulations to the organizing team. Thank you so much, Ajay Jadhav. The students, the platform is open for you.
Yeah, I found many of the higher secondary students here. So if you have any doubt regarding any of the courses or something you wanted to know about this field, you can kindly put forth your question. It is an open platform to put forth your questions.
I can see some of our alumni here as school teachers, school psychologists, who's also there in the webinar. Thank you so much, Kritika, for joining us.
Thank you, ma'am. It was my pleasure to join this session.
We're happy to have our students. But being a senior of the school students, I want to say psychology is a very good, interesting and easy subject. You have to pursue with the subject. Thank you, Ms. Anjali Kaushik. Thank you for that. Your observations, your feedback, you can put it across. Srivarshini, you have the feedback link there.
Yeah, ma'am. So I just wanted to inform regarding that, ma'am. So I thought once the question session
was coming, questions. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
You can also keep your observations recorded. You can also tell us how you feel about the webinar. It's an open platform. All I would say for the school students is usually we need a lot of clarity before taking up any subject for that matter. So we, the Kanika Parmeshwari Arts and Science College for Women, thought we will give a detailed version of what is psychology, how it will be really useful for you, and that is the agenda for having such a webinar. So please utilize it and get the best out of you. Even for your siblings, you want to recommend, you can do it.
I saw Mr. Vikram unmuting. May I know who you are? Introduce yourself first and then come forward with the questions. We request you to introduce yourself and come forward with the questions. You need not hesitate. Ms. Anjali, this is a recorded version. Probably we can give you the information, but not the full recorded content. Thank you. Srivarshini?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, if there are no questions, looks like there are no questions.
Yes, ma'am.
Kritika, you have any questions for your own students' community, Ms. Kritika?
Ma'am, yeah, it's like you attended all the fields of the psychology, ma'am. I was very happy with that. Hope that everyone are clear with that, ma'am.
Okay, all right. Yes, ma'am. I think actually, the notes were clear. So that maybe that's the reason either we understand completely, we don't have any questions. I take it that way positively. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes.
Yeah. So, ma'am, shall we?
Yes. You're there to propose the vote of thanks?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, ma'am.
Yeah, please continue.
So, anyway, the next slide, please.
There is a question by Anjali Kaushik. How can we know our interest? The more frequently that you are working on for something, the more passionate, at least with the intensity and frequency, will help you out to know what you are better, especially your interest, Anjali. There might be some confusions, I agree. It is very common, sometimes not to have any interest at all also. But sometimes there is some spark in your system that happens when you get more information. So probably that might help you, Anjali. Yes, ma'am. Srivarshini, you may continue.
Yeah, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. So, thank you so much for coming here and joining us today. So, here I go with a formal vote of thanks. Gratitude is the greatest attitude that takes you to greatest altitude. I would like to propose the vote of thanks on behalf of Sri Kanyaka Parameshwari Arts and Science College for Women's Department of Psychology. I would first like to thank our college management, our honorable correspondent, sir, Sri Gugulam Ramesh, sir, our phenomenal principal, ma'am, Dr. Deep Mohanashree, ma'am, our vibrant vice principal, ma'ams, Dr. P.B. Vanita, ma'am, the IQAC coordinator, and Dr. M.V. Napine, ma'am, our academic vice principal. And I will also like to thank our head of the department, Dr. N. Nirmala, ma'am, and the other staffs or faculties of our own department. And I would also like to thank the higher secondary school students who have taken initiative to know about what is the field of psychology, and those who have come here to know and given you input over here. And I would also like to thank the alumni of our own department for here to be a part of this wonderful webinar today. And finally, I would like to thank the student support that made this event a very successful. So thank you so much to Ben and all for giving your contribution to this wonderful webinar in careers in psychology. And thank you so much. And I would like to give you one statement regarding the feedback. So the feedback link will be shared formally with the mail ID that the registration has been taken place. So the participants will be receiving your feedback links through the mail that you have registered, and after filling that, you will be receiving your UE certificate of participation. And we are here to confirm you that we will be sending your certificates as soon as possible. So please kindly bear with us for 10 days as the strength of the participants increases, the process of the certification delays. So kindly please bear with that. And we hope it was an enjoyable session today. So thank you so much to win and all.
I would like to make a specific mention. I want to thank all the participants. Being a May Day, you had really made it up. Thank you, school students. And there are a couple of people who are not the school students, they are college students also. Thank you for joining us. I would like to thank Ms. Lakshmi ma'am for coordinating the whole event. And special thanks to my students who always, gives us a strong support. Sri Varshini and many other girls who are behind the screen. And I guess I have not left out any names. Boneshwari, Sri Varshini, Niveda, Monica, Maithili, Lavantika, Shakti, Ramesh, Nandini, and whoever has worked, Magdalene, behind the screen, whoever has worked for the PPT. Thank you so much. Once again, I thank my management committee members, my principal, vice principal, and all my staff members. Thank you. Chalo, bye. Take care. Have a beautiful day ahead. Thank you so much. Sri, we can stop the recording. Please post the attendance link.
Yeah, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
And those who fill the attendance link alone will get these certificates.